Hello YouTube, it's Wednesday, August 10th, and I've got enough of these videos here. I've got it pretty well pegged at what's going on. The biggest problem when the first one came out, I looked at it and I said, well, the orientation's off. Normally the satellites, the solar satellites, are aligned in what they call the ecliptic orientation, which lines the planets up along the ecliptic at a horizon type of view on the cameras. This is not that way. And the first one was kind of hard because there's so many stars here. There's no time. There's no time on it. There's not any labels on it. But I figured out that these two stars here are the key. These two stars are these two stars, and on the latest one, the eighth here, it's the same two stars right here. And if you take a look at it, you can figure out that it's these two stars right here that we're looking at. This is, like I say, what they call the ecliptic orientation. That's the normal orientation for the satellites, with the ecliptic right here, and the planets along the ecliptic where they move basically right and left. In this particular instance, they roll the satellite out of the ecliptic orientation. It's in basically a local satellite orientation, and that doesn't even match what I have for the Earth local orientation. So it's going to be off. But if you take an You take and rotate it back over into what they call the local orientation, it gives it close to what you're getting on the movies. It's not exact because, like I say, the local orientation on the program is meant for Earth. It's not meant for the satellites, so it's still off. And I had to take and rotate these things. When I look at the pictures, I've got to have it in the same orientation to really determine what I'm looking at. There's so many stars here, you have to break it down into each one separately and zoom in and out to get the stars to show up in the program. It's a major pain in the butt. But you see the two stars right here. If you take and run the program ahead, you can see it move right up in between the two stars, just like it shows on this picture on the video here. It's moving right in between the two stars. And another problem is if you get all the stars to show up on the program really gets slow. And you can put all the labels on there, and the program hardly moves at all. It starts getting really laggy. But we're going to take and look at a few of them. And first thing I'm going to do is we'll go back to the 7th. And on the 7th, I've determined that the best time is around 9:40, give or take. But that's about the closest I can peg it to a time. And so here's your two stars over there, and we'll take and zoom in on it. And right here you can see that the first notable thing is these four up here. There's one really dim one right there, and you got the three bright ones here. And what I did with the movies, since the movies, I wasn't able to rotate the movies to where it matched the program. I can't rotate the program to match the movies. So what I did was I just rotated, made a picture, exported a picture, and I rotated the picture to match the program. And that way I was able to take and get a little better view of what was going on. Here's a picture rotated 45 degrees. Here's your two stars. That's these two stars here. And we can take and zoom in a little bit on it there, and you see this area up there. That's the stars we're looking at right here. You got three bright ones and one dimmer one. And like I say, you can get it to show all the stars, and you can get it to label all the stars. And when you do, it gets really slow. And we'll turn the stars up, and I'm going to keep the labels down. You can put it all the way to where all the labels are there, and then you can't see a thing. So we'll turn the labels down for now. And now you can see the little star over here, the dim one, a little bit better. Like I say, that's this one right, this group right here. Here's your star. That's this one here. Then you got these three, the one dimmer one, and then out away from the dimmer one, you've got this one here and that one there. That's this one here, and there's a real dim one there. And you got the other one up there. That's this one over here. And you can go through, I've gone through and looked at it, and you have to go to a certain section of the video and zoom in on it, and then you can take and figure out what stars are what. It's kind of hard otherwise. Now you see these are the two up here, and then you got three that run down alongside the comet, three bright ones. The three that run down alongside the comet. There's so many stars when you do that. So many stars, everywhere you put the pointer, you get a star showing up. Okay, so go back again. Here's your three running alongside the comet. That's these three right here. And then you can see two dim ones in between this star. That's these two dim ones right here. If you take and zoom it in, it'll show the other one. And then you got the other one right there. That's this one right here. And you got this little trio right there. That's this little trio right there. And you got the two in back of the comet right there. That's these two right here. And then you got the three over here alongside the comet. That's these three right here. And from those three there, you got these little two up here. You go along there, and those are little two right there. So like I say, you can take and zoom in to each little area. You can label each little star, and it works out. In other words, here's your three again. There's your three again. And if you look down from the third one, you'll see this grouping down here. You got a double star there, a double star there. Okay, so if you go to the third one here and you go down, here's your double star here. Here's your double star there. That's this one here, and this two here, there, and there. And then star over here is this star down there. So I'm not going to waste very much time on it. I've gone through the videos, and I'm satisfied that it's basically a match, just like the other video I did from the Canary Island Observer. It's a match, and I looked at all three videos, and it basically is a match. And you've got this group up here, that's this group over here, the three there, the two dimmer ones and the bright one, the two dimmer ones and the bright one. And you got these over here, that's these over here. You zoom it in and it'll show every little star on there. This one here is that one there, and then that one there is this brighter one here. And you got the little triangle again. That's the little triangle again. And it just goes on and on and on and on. So I'm convinced that it's correct. And we got to get out of this large number of star thing, or the program would be so slow it's ridiculous. And that's the major problem. You're looking at a spacecraft orientation that doesn't match anything on my star program, and it's not used to what you're seeing. When they rolled the spacecraft around, it really messed it up with the orientation that you're used to. And this is the last one there. And we can take and pull up the image that I made on that. And basically it's showing the same thing. In other words, here's your two stars. The comet's in between the two stars. Here's your three stars and your dimmer one. Here's your three stars and a dimmer one. Same thing, you zoom in and it'll bring out all these little stars out, and you'll be able to see them. These two down here are these two right here, and so forth and so on. So looking at the website here, they keep adding the movies to it as they come in, and they're going through which ones, and they still don't say which ones is possibly going to show up on the stereo, but we've already gone through that in the last video. The Ellen on Stereo's video showed that it's probably going to be Stereo A Core 2, and it's going to be so far away, the comet's going to be 1.5 AU away from Stereo A, and it's possible you're not going to see it. That's why they say possibly Stereo Core 2, because it's going to be so far away you might not be able to see it. Depends on how bright the comet gets. And then when it goes to the SOHO, we went through that also, 6 days in the SOHO. And if you notice, the Venus is now showing up on SOHO C2 instead of the C3. It's finally got close enough to show up on there. And as far as the pictures go, now I don't know why people can't find pictures of this stuff. Now, this is the last one that I had from our Canary Island observer, and he says on here, you should take note of this now. When he took that last picture that I had in my video, that the comet was only 10 degrees above the horizon, and it's getting worse. The star is getting, or the comet is getting close to our star, the sun. When it gets close, you're not going to be able to see it. It's going to be too close. So all earthbound cameras, telescopes, whatever, are not going to see the comet till it passes across the sun and comes out the other side. And then it will be viewable in the morning instead of late in the evening like it's visible right now. So it's not going to be very much longer before you're not going to get any pictures, but there are so many pictures on here. I really don't understand why people are having a hard time finding them. I've been all over it, and there's pictures everywhere. Here's another one right here of Ellen. You can go through his file, his whole, he has a file full of them. They're all over the place. Here's the one that I had in my last video. And as he said, it's only 10 degrees above the horizon because it's getting close to the sun. That's the one where I talked about the diameter of it, went through the diameter of the coma. I still don't understand why people don't understand what a coma is. Basically, I think they understand what it is, they're just trying to be contrary. It's the only thing I can think of. And so you can go on down through the list here, and this guy here has a large number of images that go way back. He's been putting down images for quite a while. If you go through his stack, he's got a lot of Al-Anon pictures. And he's got images that go way, way back. Same observer. He's got all sorts of images there. And you can even go back to the French observer. He's in here somewhere. He's got a long list of them. This is one of 10 of 46, so you've got a lot of them in here. I'm not going to bother going through these images. I'll put this link down here. It's a search link at Yahoo Groups. And you just click on these, and you can go there, and you can find their file on Ellen, and there's all sorts of pictures there. And you're going to have to look at them for the next few weeks because the comet's getting too close to the sun. When the comet gets too close to the sun, you're not going to see it anymore. Not until it gets out the other side, and that's exactly what's happening. Okay, I can go back to the ecliptic orientation. And as you see, the comet is getting close to the sun. And when the comet gets too close to the sun, you're not going to be able to see it with a camera on the Earth. When it pops out the other side, you'll be able to see it. So we'll take and go to my little corner of the world. And we'll take and line back up on the sun. And you see we're in the ecliptic orientation. There's all sorts of different ones you can choose from. And here's a comet right here, and as you see, the comet is getting close to the sun. We can take and speed it up. As the comet gets closer to the sun, you're going to lose it. can look right here. Right here, it's only 31 degrees away from the sun. And getting closer all the time. And like I say, right now you're looking at it when the sun sets. You're not going to be looking at it when it gets to here, though. And it's going to have to get way over here and pop out before you're going to be able to see it in the morning, just before sunrise. So if you can't find any pictures now, you're going to have a really hard time finding pictures in the next few weeks. You will be able to see the pictures off of the satellites, however. And if you go back to the our space obs here, he's talking about a couple other satellites coming up with images. And that's good, because like I say, you're fixing to lose all earthbound cameras because it's going to be too close to the sun as seen from Earth. So I'm going to leave it at that. And like I say, we can go through these pictures and zoom in, and I can name every one of these stars down here. It takes a long time. So I'll talk to you later.